We will start with the model building workflow diagrams you are now hopefully becoming familiar with. These diagrams will guide us through our model building and validation process and help you follow the thought process needed to build robust models. At the time of writing this lesson, there has been widespread suspicion that Medicare is being severely harmed by some fraudulent charges, and that large portions of payouts are allegedly going to a very tiny portion of providers. Less than a month after the dataset was released, people already found some interesting things in the data. For example, the New York Times, in this article by Reed Abelson and Sarah Cohen, published on April 9, 2014, writes about how the data reveals a single ophthalmologist who was paid $21 million in the course of a single year. We've put a link to this article in the instructor's notes. To identify and reduce cases of fraud in Medicare, the government has released the data to anyone who wants to inspect and see what is in it. We could try to answer this call to action. Together, we can examine the raw data released by the US government in order to detect anomalous behavior. Along the way, we'll learn methods for building models. So now we can ask the first question. How do we detect if there are anomalous charges in the Medicare data? That question immediately leads to the next question. How do we define anomalies in data? To give you an intuitive understanding, if you have all your data clustered together here in one region, and you have some points far away, like these red X's, we can consider the red points here as outliers. Anomalies can also show up as peaks and bumps in distributions. In this case, we can have an original distribution with a little bump in the tail here. This bump might indicate some sort of anomaly in the data. Another way we define anomalies in the data is by looking at domain-specific signatures. Imagine, for example, a sequence of events in logs indicating an intrusion in a data center. We are going to further investigate outliers in distributions by looking at simple non-parametric statistical techniques. We're going to start looking at the Medicare data from the Centers for Medicare and Medicaid Services website. The link is provided in the instructor's notes. If you click on the link, you will come to the page that looks like this. From the website, look for the link that says Inpatient Charges for Fiscal Year 2012. Clicking on that link will take you to the page where you can download the data. You're welcome to use the entire data set, especially if you want to explore the data further than we do in the lesson here. However, to make things easier and faster, we have reduced the original data set and put the needed files in the instructor's notes. So look for files with Illinois and California in the instructor's notes, and that's the files we are going to use for the rest of this lesson. As in the previous lessons, we will be using the IPython notebook to perform the analysis. Look in the instructor's notes if you have any further questions as to how to get started with the notebook for this lesson. We now set up some of the libraries that we will need to use for this lesson. We're going to use Seaborn and Matplotlib for plotting. We're going to use Pandas for handling the dataset. If you scroll down further, you will see a file in the Medicare data folder that says Medicare Data Illinois 2012.csv. This is a comma-separated variable file. We created this file specially for you so that you don't have to use the entire data set. If you're interested in using the entire data set, use these commented out codes here to load the entire data set. Now we use the read CSV library from Pandas to read the data and load it into a data frame. As before, to run this piece of code, we just use the play button here. Once the data set is finished loading, you will receive a message like this. The F_IL is the pandas data frame. We can use the describe function to look at a summary of this data. Let's run this piece of code. Once this finishes running, you should have a table that looks like this. The total number of events we have in the data frame is 387,623. You can slide this bar here to look at the rest of the table. Now let's look at the top 5 lines of the data frame. We can do that by using the head command. Once you finish running that, you will see another table. This table shows the actual data that has been loaded to memory. The top row gives you the names of various columns in the pandas data frame. Each column consists of a NumPy array. If you're not familiar with pandas data frames, we have linked to a lesson in the intro to data science where it will teach you the high-level concepts and about pandas and data frames. If you scroll further down, you will see it shows 5 rows and 28 columns. The 28 columns indicate there are 28 vectors in the pandas data frame. Use the box below to write a Python code that uses the file for California included in your instructor's notes. Load it to memory as a pandas data frame and print a summary of the data. Once you have finished writing your code in this box provided here, click on this box.